Hello and welcome to the NDTV Dialogues. Today we have a very special episode because we have a book launch on this show as well. And this book is about education. And joining me is the author of that book, Delhi's Deputy Chief Minister, Education Minister and Finance Minister, Manish Sisodia. Manish, tell us about this book and thank you for launching it here. What is this book about?
Thank you for giving me the opportunity of this TV launch of the book Shiksha, written by me. And it's a pleasure to be here with the idea of book and talk to all these young minds here. This book is about the journey of last four and a half years in Delhi Education Department, working as Education Minister. There are lots of ups and downs, lot of learnings, lot of changes. Now around the country and internationally also a lot of people ask me, ki, what are the things that have been done? What are the big changes that you have made? So it was not possible for me to list out what was important and what was not important. So I have narrated all accounts, every nitty-gritty in this book. I mean, sort of every nitty-gritty in this book so that people can understand it. Let's hope that there would be a day in India when again we'll reinforce our trust into government education system.
Of course.
That is losing.
And as you said, we have an audience of young, bright children, some teachers and parents. So are you all excited today?
Yeah.
So Manishi, this journey of now almost 4.5 years, first what's interesting is that usually an education minister is never in much prominence. In fact, you mentioned in the book that the country doesn't have an education minister. We just have a human resource development minister. Why did you choose education as a priority? Why not one of the, you are finance minister, of course, but why do you think education has been your main focus?
So it's not my priority versus parties or government priority. It should be the national priority. Whatever we are struggling with, we have not prioritized education for all. We have said that Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, education all, no child left behind. These are just slogans, but we have not made sure that each and every child sitting, living in a city or in any state should get at least this much of minimum quality of education. So it's not about prioritizing, it's the need. If we don't work on education, everything would be false, everything would be temporary. If we work on education first and then think on, give priority to other things, then only we can have a solid country, solid economy. Otherwise, everything is very temporary.
The good thing also is that by being education and finance minister, that I think Delhi is the only state in the country which has given 26% of its budget to education. Tell us about that decision, because you write in the book also of how when you first walked into government classrooms, what your experience was and why that was such an important shift you had to make.
You see, yes, it's a privilege to be finance minister and education minister, together. But again, we are running a government and we have all sort of department that any other state is having. Also, we are having a lot of other challenges that other states are having in different ways. We have 70% of the Delhi is living in either slums or unauthorized colonies, which are never developed. We have those also to be developed. We were having 58% of Delhi was getting water supply. Rest of it was not having. But still, as I said, we have to prioritize. And in 2015, when we came to power, a lot of pressure was there. A lot of expectations were from every angle, from staff, from slums, from unauthorized colonies, from regularized colonies, from DDA flats. Everybody was expecting something for them. We said, first we choose education. That's why we kept 25% of our budget, which we doubled actually. So obviously it was a hard decision, but yes, we were firm that we'll give priority to education. And we are glad after 4.5 years that we worked on education. We had a lot of money to work on education, but being an honest government, we got a lot of money. Delhi people pay a lot of taxes, but there was a lot of siphoning off also. When we started, the budget of Delhi was 30,000 crore rupees. Every year it was increasing at the rate of 1,000 crore rupees before us. But now it's increasing almost 6,000-7,000 crore rupees per year. So we are getting enough budget also to work on. So education is a priority, but we are getting money for other priorities also.
You've said this also, that what seemed to anger you the most, if they say Manish Sisodia ko gussa kyun aata hai, is the belief that there should be different standards for children of a certain class and children of the poor or children who go to government schools. What for you summed that up, or what was the most obvious
example? As I said, I have said in this book also that we are not the first government who is talking about education in our country. Mm-hmm. It's not that we have built these AIIMS, IIMs, IITs. We have never built all this. We are just 4-year government and 6-year old politicians. What we are focusing is, and what others or in past we India has been doing, it's not about any party or any person. A lot of people have contributed a lot across the parties. Mm-hmm. But still where we have been lacking is that we have been working sky is the limit. Let's set up good skies. Let's have schools where we can send our kids to ISRO, NASA and all. But what about the, this is limited to 5% of the students, 10% of the students. What about the 90% of the other students? When I went to schools, I found, especially in government schools, in many private schools also, but in government school, I found that 174 students were enrolled in one section. How can a teacher, I mean, you can't make all 174 stand together in one classroom. And we say, yeah, if you ask us as a minister before this or as a government, yes, yes, sir, you are wrong about our perception. We have very good government schools in Delhi. I should have said, show me, kya hai? Sir, we have this Pratibha school, we have this school, we have that school, 5, 6, 10 schools we are, or maybe 20 schools we are. Out of 1,000 schools, if you have 20 good schools and rest 980 schools are worse than anything, then there is nothing we are doing. That made me angry, and that made me to think that we have to focus on education. Otherwise, we can't work.
Mm-hmm. Also, do you see it as a way of equality, that you have to provide equal standards of education? Why does it make a difference what the desk or blackboard and all is like? Why do you think it's also an issue of pride?
It makes a dignity. I went to a school, and actually one student told me, sir, hum desh ka bhavishya thode hai. Desh ka bhavishya to private school mein padhta hai. I said, if one student coming to a government school is thinking, that was in 2015. I said, why? Sir, aap desk dekhiye na hamare yahan. O dari, tooti hui dari, uspe paani bhar raha hai, chhat tooti hui hai. Ab uspe baithe hue bacche se main kahun, tum desh ka bhavishya ho. Mujhe khud pe sharm aani chahiye, kehte hue. So I took a note from that scene and I told Chief Minister that we have to work around the clock on education. Then only we can do something. Now, students are sitting here. I'm not sure that I have made every school full of every facility, but I can say there is a minimum guarantee that I can provide right now. I can assure you in all 1,000 schools, you will find good quality desk student to be seated, at least good sanitation facilities, at least good water facilities, at least good ambience in the school about teaching. Then now I can say these are the minimum things we have fixed. Now sky is the limit. If you have leakages here, you can't even reach sky.
So I'll ask, and we have students from across schools, because that's the way it should be. Students of India, whatever school they're from, government or private, shouldn't matter. What do you all think? Have your schools changed? Have the government schools changed?
Definitely the government schools have changed. I am from School of Excellence, Kalkaji, which is a government school, and I can see the changes, the infrastructure, the desks, and even the quality of education, the books and all. Everything is the same as private schools. When we go to the competition, zonal level and district levels, then we don't feel that we are from a school where we are not getting proper facilities like these children. We feel that all of us are equal now.
That's wonderful. And I know children are not scared, so don't be scared that the minister is sitting here. I said, no, but I have to say our journalists have also found many of the same things. So in fact, I just wanted to ask, because the focus always, parents will always say, ki, achha, desa, okay, what are the results? And I think this year, the government schools have had record results. How has that turnaround come in 4 years?
I never see good quality desk and better facilities, 5-star building as the achievement of Delhi government in schools. They are needed. They are needed to make a teacher comfortable that the system with I am working cares for me, care for my sanitation things. If I need to spend 8 hours in one school, at least system is thinking, providing me to some clean, neat and clean space to at least sit for some time, spend some time in my staff room, when I am going to class, or everything is not littering around. So that's a matter of just peace. That's a matter of just confidence. But it is not the target. It's a medium. Medium is better citizen, better qualified citizen. For that, twofold. First year, we spent most of our attention on infrastructure. When this took off, I'm not saying completed, took off, we started working on teaching ambience. We I asked my teachers that if, and I told my teachers, if I want you to deliver world-class education, I need to help you what the world is doing actually. So we made possibilities of teacher trainings across the globe, Singapore, Finland, Cambridge, Harvard, everywhere we are sending our teachers to get trained. That was our second year. Third year, we started on curriculum, examination patterns and curriculum. And fortunately, for last 3 years, I can say, government school result is improving a lot, which earlier used to be around 80%+. Now it's 96%. Mm-hmm. It has crossed this year.
And that's a record. That's
it's a record.
No, because that comes amid a time when the BJP and Manoj Tiwari, the state president, attacked you for saying that too much money is being sent on classrooms. It's a huge scam. Why do you need to do all this? This is how the AAP is making money on classrooms.
You see, first of all, they're just trying to pose something. I mean, they don't have anything to show. So they're there to just tell, dekhe ye nahi ho raha hai, wo nahi ho raha hai, gadbad ho gaya, wo gadbad ho gaya. I'm making classrooms, good quality classroom, and I'm proud of it. I'm spending money on schools, I'm proud of it. And I say this with challenge, if you have guts, you please spend money on education in your state where you have government. I'm doing it for the future of the country, and I have no shame on it, I have no regret of it. Whatever money we are spending, don't go on mathematics, they have their own mathematics, this much money divided by this many classrooms. I'm spending on sports grounds also, I'm spending on labs also, libraries also. So I know where I'm spending the money that I'm being given by taxpayers. Mm-hmm. But again, I would say that unfortunately, BJP is a party which does not have understanding of education, which does not have any work that they can showcase around the country. They have government in a lot of states now, across the states. I have challenged them again and again, that why do you come on those mathematics and all this, this much money divided by this? Show me a room which you have constructed. I show you my room which I have constructed. Tell me a quality result where you say that this is our government school system in our state, any state you choose across the India. I choose Delhi because I am education minister of Delhi. And let's have a better competition. Let's have a positive competition. Even if you win, India wins. Even if I win, India wins.
Well, that's a challenge I hope other governments do take up. But just that point, because I had said earlier about education ministry is an interesting ministry because often some politicians like it, some others take it because the seat is an ideological ministry. The bit you made about India's future that, you know, that this, we want to rewrite textbooks, we want to rewrite history, we want to correct history, however you interpret it. But ideologically, it's a very important ministry because the future of India is there. What do you think about it, the ideology of an education ministry, and what's the ideology you have?
We are living in 21st century, and the competition these kids have is not within their classes or within their school or within Delhi. Now a student sitting in any slum of Delhi is having competition with a student studying in Singapore or American village also, because it's a global age. So we have to make them global. We have to make them understand. We have to make them ready for the jobs which do not exist today. That is my ideology. Mm-hmm. We have to make them ready to face the challenges that actually do not exist today. Nobody knows what challenge they are going to face tomorrow when they are into colleges or when they are into actually jobs. Mm-hmm. So we have to make them ready for that. The history is available on Google. There are so many writers and then so many versions. So let's be happy with that. Let's create our future.
No, but you have the new HRD minister who makes the point that everything of today has been already been done by India in the Vedas. We already did this in Sanskrit times. What would you say to the Sonia, education
I think,
HRD
I
minister
think
on that?
We should spend our time in talking some better things.
Okay.
I'm not discarding, but I don't subscribe their ideologies. I don't subscribe their way of thinking on education. For me, education is, first of all, my children should learn how to live happy and how to help to get that ability to make others happy. Mm-hmm. They should be entrepreneurs. They should be, well equipped with the etiquette and ethics to be a better citizen, better entrepreneurs. They should be ready to contribute to the economy of the country. I need them to take there with me. Of course, the country need to go there. And if we want them to struggle with Hanumanji ki jati kya thi, come on. We can talk it later.
No, but what's interesting is that Delhi government schools now have a Desh Bhakti curriculum, which is not necessarily something which is would be seen as education of the future, but it's a Deshbhakti curriculum. Many would say that this is the BJP's nationalistic version.
Actually, when we say Deshbhakti, Deshbhakti does not mean just a fundamentalist idea. And that's why I want to, reopen the word Deshbhakti. That's why I deliberately used this word, Deshbhakti. Deshbhakti sirf Bharat-Pakistan ki match ke waqt taali bajane ki baat nahi hai. Deshbhakti sirf TV news pe khabar dekh ke ki acha Bharat ne Pakistan ko itna karara jawab de diya aur mere desh ki bhakti santusht ho gayi uski baat nahi hai. Deshbhakti is baat mein bhi hai ki main agar gaadi chala ke ja raha hu aur red light pe jump kar raha hu to mere andar question paida ho ki main deshbhakt hu ki nahi hu. Deshbhakti is baat mein bhi hai ki if I am going to an office and I am going there for some certificate, say caste certificate or OBC, residence certificate, A certificate, and there is a queue and I intend to get my work done on priority by paying bribe, then I should ask myself, ki main deshbhakt hoon ki nahi hoon. I want my kids to learn that. Mm-hmm. I want my students to practice that. It's not about just clapping on the India-Pakistan match. Deshbhakti is a big thing. Desh badi cheez hai, desh ki bhakti badi cheez hai, humne usko bada limited kar diya hai.
And it's not about, you don't think all this rewriting history and rewriting textbooks?
Dekho, I love my history. I love India's history and I feel proud of it. Mm-hmm. But I usually say ki agar aapko aage badhna hai na, to you have to learn from the technology of car driving. In a car when you drive, agar aap bade matlab wo piche dekhne wala shisha hai na, usko bada kar loge to aap accident ho jayega. Car ko agar aapko aage badhana hai to aapko aage dikhne wala jo glass hai usi ko bada rakhna padega, piche dekhne wale glass ko usi ratio mein aapko chhota sa rakhna padega. It's needed. Mm-hmm. It's important. कि आप पीछे नजर रखें, आपकी हिस्ट्री पे नजर रखें, पर अगर आप हिस्ट्री में ही झांकते रहोगे तो सामने दो मिनट बाद आप भी हिस्ट्री बन जाओगे. सो वी हैव टू लर्न फ्रॉम दैट.
ऑफ कोर्स आई एम गोइंग टू ओपन दिस अप टू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट्स. रोहित राठौर,
माय क्वेश्चन इज टू सर दैट एज अ एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर, व्हाट इज योर मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ ईएमसी एंड फ्रॉम वेयर यू इंस्पायर टू ओपन दिस करिकुलम इन द स्कूल?
आई मीट लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु हैव गॉन out of India and they're doing their business, they're doing some job in big multinational
companies. EMC is the entrepreneurship.
Mindset curriculum. And I discussed with them. Mm-hmm. There are so many, it actually triggered in one meeting with one very big businessman who has gone to India and who is making chips in US. He came to meet me. He said, you are doing something good in education, but he's making chips there and he's supplying those chips to NASA and all. He said, the main problem I have found in education in India is that we don't create entrepreneurship mindset. We give entrepreneurship skills. We made good engineers, we made good data analysts, we good best of the best software professional, manager, advocate. We are creating best of the best professionals the world can look for. But we are not creating entrepreneurship mindsets. Mindset is very important. Unless you have that mindset of entrepreneurship, you can only seek a job. You can become a job seeker with that skill. Mm-hmm. So taking a clue from that meeting, he said that India could, that person said, I was living in India. I could have devoted my time in India and could have contributed to Indian economy if I was doing the same business from India. But since Indian people does not, Indian education system does not give entrepreneurship mindset, then he said, I went to US, I got 2 years of other education there, I got that mindset and now I have set up my business there. I thought, and that triggered into my mind, and I thought that if in Delhi itself we are producing 250,000 students every year from our schools as school graduates, if we give them entrepreneurship mindset, so we'll be giving 250,000 professionals who are ready to take up any job or who are ready to initiate any business. If they initiate businesses, if they start business, then they'll become job providers. Not only they'll become job providers, their product will be contributing to Indian economy also. Whatever they are producing right now, best of our best brains, what they do is they go to America, they work for some American or European or Japanese companies, a software and a mobile, which is being prepared by an Indian guy for one American or European company, is being sold anywhere in the world, the profit goes to that country. If that guy is here, setting up his or her company here, he's or she's an entrepreneur, then all the profit will be coming to India, all the jobs will be coming to India, so India will be growing.
Of course. And we have also Sarthak Kapoor wants to ask a question. Sarthak, go ahead.
Sir, as we have witnessed the success of happiness scheme launched by your government, I would like to ask you that what were the methods and exercises of that comprises in this happiness curriculum? And how does a happiness class look like?
You're from a private school, Sarthak?
Yeah, it's
so would you like happiness curriculum in your school?
We have from like past few years.
Okay, so maybe they've taken a leaf from there. I'm sure many schools now are looking.
Yeah, there are many private schools who have started or who are starting now in Delhi and otherwise also across the country. In Nepal also the school, there is private school association. They have contacted us to train their teachers. Many other universities are starting. But anyway, his question is, what is happiness curriculum about? In my opinion, the ultimate purpose of education is, I quote here, to learn how to live my life happily and to get that ability so that I can help others to live happily. Whatever I do, I become an advocate, I should have ability to make others, I mean, help others to live their life happily. Happiness class is emotional science class. It's not, happiness is a word, but we should understand what we teach there. We teach there emotional science. What are your emotions? In what condition? How do you react emotionally? Then only you can react better. If you don't know how emotionally, just say, ek bahut simple se example, he asked what kind of exercise you do. Har aadmi sochta hai ki main ek aadmi hoon, ye bhi ek aadmi hai. Main kuch galti nahi karta hoon, ye kabhi kabhi galti kar deta hai. Jab main galti karta hoon, to mujhe pyar se samjhaya jana chahiye. क्योंकि मैं जानबूझ के गलती नहीं करता हूं पर दूसरा आदमी कई बार हम मानते हैं तो जानबूझ के गलती करता है और ये तो बिना डंडे के समझेगा नहीं अपनी हर गलती पे मुझे लगता है कि मैंने जानबूझ के नहीं की मुझे प्यार से समझाओ ना दूसरे की हर गलती पे लगता है कि ये तो जानबूझ के ही करता है उसको डंडे के बिना नहीं समझा सकते ये इमोशनल डिफरेंस है ये इमोशनल लर्निंग हम क्लास में सिखाते हैं कि आप अपने बारे में समझ लीजिए जब अपने बारे में समझ पाएंगे तो दूसरे के बारे में भी समझ जाओगे फिर झगड़े खत्म हो जाएंगे
But while they have happiness in all, this now not Delhi, but I'm asking your views in education across India. If you look at the ASSAR report, which is I think one of the few reports that tracks learnings, we saw that in government schools across India, though it's improved, the 2018 data says that of children enrolled in standard 8 in India, 73% can read standard 2 level text. Maths mein, it's a similar situation. How do we take, say, maybe the Delhi experiment with the results, and how do we look at doing this across government schools? Also in the ASSAR report, it shows that more and more parents, even parents from a lower economic background, are taking loans to put their children in private schools because they feel private schools maybe will get education, we don't trust government education. How do we change this, not just for Delhi, but across India?
First of all, government ko tay karna padega. All the governments have to be firm that yes, we can re-establish the confidence of government school system. Governments don't have confidence in their own systems. I met a lot of education ministers and I asked them that why I keep hearing news about your state and you are closing a lot of government schools in your state, you are not able to run them or what? They say, no, actually students are not coming there. So I have developed a habit of asking them again that can you give me some data that wherever there are government schools you are closing, can you give me some data about that how many private schools have emerged there? And how many of the private schools that have emerged there are being owned by politicians and government officials or maybe their relatives? If you start nurturing private schools around government schools which are being owned by politicians, local politicians or whatever, influencers, then how can you expect? I mean, it's their business then. They won't love the government schools to function on quality. So nobody has actually given me this data, but I assume that wherever we are closing down schools at large level, we are serving the business of private school. I'm not saying private school, I respect a lot of private schools, I'm not, but we are serving the private school business in our country, and we should not.
Because you've made that point, and private schools were upset with you in a sense, because you had said earlier that if they want profit, they should open a mithai ka dukaan or become halwais. And they're upset because on the issue of, say, fees. They say, if we want to give quality education, we need to pay our teachers certain fees, or we need to have the freedom to be allowed to run our schools how we want. Why should the government interfere?
In Delhi, I have given them complete freedom. What the way you teach, I never intervene. The government never intervene. What you want to charge from the student, the law says you can only charge what you are spending. you can't charge more than what you are spending. That's my struggle with them. If you are charging more what you are spending, then I'll stop you. I'll check you. If you are charging that much only, I'm happy, charge. If you are paying your teachers, say, 1 lakh rupees, fair enough, charge that fees from the students. If you are paying your teachers 20,000 or 30,000 rupees, and you are charging them on the account of 1 lakh rupees, then I am going to object this.
In fact, but however, the biggest challenge in India's education system, perhaps it has almost created a kind of apartheid, is the fact that some children go to private schools, those who can afford it go to private schools, and those who don't afford it, can't afford it, go to government schools. In fact, the question has been that until our politicians and bureaucrats put their children into government schools, the quality won't change. What would you say on that?
I doubt that will help in change in quality. The quality will change when you are committed to provide quality education to all. Yesterday only, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, when we were launching this book, he said that if we pass this law, it's very easy to pass this law, pass this mandate. But what will happen? My Which son law, or any VIP son, any minister, any officer's son or daughter going to that school, the whole system will be focused ki ye wala school theek kar dete hain. Wo 20-25 school to pehle bhi theek hai, yaar. Aapko guarantee is baat ke liye nahi hai ki jisme kisi minister ka aur kisi officer ka bachcha nahi padhta hai. रिक्शे वाले के बच्चे पढ़ते हैं सारे सब्जी वाले के बच्चे पढ़ते हैं सारे एक जॉब डूअर जो 40-30-40 हज़ार रुपए की जॉब करता है कोई प्राइवेट आदमी गवर्नमेंट आदमी उसके बच्चे पढ़ते हैं उनको कौन पढ़ाएगा फिर ये तो बहुत आसान है ये इस थ्योरी को मैं बहुत ज़्यादा सब्सक्राइब नहीं करता हूँ जब तक आप सारे स्कूल के लिए नहीं सोचोगे आप सोच लीजिए 20-25-40 स्कूल ऐसे हो जाएंगे दिल्ली में सारे लोगों के बच्चे वहीं पढ़ा करेंगे सब लोग जुगाड़ लगा के अपने कहेंगे हाँ जी हमने वी आर वेरी लॉ अबाइडिंग सिटीजन हम अपने बच्चों को गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में पढ़ा रहे हैं अब वो अलग बात है कि हम दिल्ली के बेस्ट 20 स्कूल्स में सारे गवर्नमेंट मिनिस्टर्स ऑफिसर्स सबके बच्चे पढ़ रहे होंगे बाकी 980 स्कूल्स 1000 में से वहाँ जिन लोगों के बच्चे पढ़ रहे होंगे उनकी कोई चिंता नहीं करेगा फिर और सब लोग खुश कहेंगे देखा हमने सारे लोग अपने बच्चों को गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में पढ़ा रहे हैं कम ऑन I don't like this.
So you don't think that it should be that you should put your son in a government school or Arvind Kejriwal should have put his children in a government school?
I don't see that to be a solution. The solution is that Arvind Kejriwal should make sure दैट जो एजुकेशन क्वालिटी उनके बच्चे को मिल रही है वही एजुकेशन क्वालिटी एक रिक्शे वाले के बच्चे को भी मिले एक सब्जी वाले के बच्चे को भी मिले दैट वी शुड वर्क अपॉन ये हम यूट्यूबियन थ्योरीज निकाल निकाल के लाते हैं उसके बाद हम एक ट्राई करते हैं फिर 20 साल बाद कहते हैं ये तो चली नहीं यार अब कुछ और कर लेते हैं इसके चक्कर में 3-4 जनरेशन निकल जाती हैं
एंड अंडर द राइट टू एजुकेशन एक्ट प्राइवेट स्कूल्स आर्ग्यू दैट द गवर्नमेंट एब्डिकेटेड इट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बाय forced integration of 25% EWS kids going to private schools. What's your view on that? Do you think that this is a way forward, that you should have a level playing field, or do you think it's not really worked?
No, it was needed. And in Delhi, at least, you see, we have to understand, when we talk about the side of the private school system or private university education system, we usually compare all this with other countries. In other countries, I'm not sure about every country, but in many countries, private school system is an accepted business. In India, private school system is not an accepted business. All the private schools are running under one law that no private school will be a profitable school. All private schools are set up by trusts. Trusts can't earn profits. There are Supreme Court orders. There are law that, and you are given a lot of benefits. You are given a lot of piece of land in Delhi. Almost 300 schools have got free land. Just by an understanding that we want our kids, our next generation, future generation to get better education. Please help in that. So taking clue from that, you got the land. And now you are trying to run a business. You should have told them that time that I want to run a business. I don't want a free land. I'll purchase this on market cost. Aap market cost pe us par khareed ke aake business karo na fir. Aap zameen sarkari lete ho. Unhi usi pe sarkar agar usko lease rent pe de deti, kai bachon ki fees nikal aati.
In fact, not just education, health also. Do you think the way forward for development for a country is that education and health should be mainly government funded and provided as a quality, with a minimum quality by the government, or should go in the private hand? Because health also is 80% private sector. Again, many hospitals also got subsidized land.
See, health and education both are nation building things. Kal ko aap kahoge army nahi chalai ja rahi, humse army ko privatize kar dete hain. Kal ko aap kahoge police nahi chalai ja rahi, hum police ko bhi private kar dete hain. हमने एजुकेशन हेल्थ पे ऑलमोस्ट गिव अप कर दिया है आज से 20 साल पहले ऐसा नहीं था हम एक नेशनल एक्सेप्टेंस में ये था कि एजुकेशन सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है सरकार जहाँ जहाँ नहीं करती है थोड़ा बहुत मदद हम मार्केट से ले सकते हैं अभी हम कह रहे हैं आपने बच्चे पैदा किए ना माँ बाप हो आप चिंता करो ये बहुत खतरनाक नोशन है, ये एटीट्यूड बहुत, देश में जो भी बच्चा पैदा हुआ है वो किसी घर का बेटा है वो ठीक है, कोई बेटी है वो ठीक है, बट वो इस देश का नागरिक भी है. एज ए नेशन वी हैव टू बी रेस्पॉन्सिबल नेशन. हम अपने फ्यूचर जनरेशन, फ्यूचर सिटीजन के लिए, इफ वी आर नॉट रेडी टू इन्वेस्ट देन वी शुड बी अशेम्ड ऑन अस. वी आर नॉट एंड आई फील पेन इन दैट.
Absolutely. In fact, we have more questions.
So my question for you is that our city has a title of the most polluted city in the world. So, sir, how do you plan to spread ecological awareness among the students so that they can tackle and become global citizens?
Yes, it is one of the most polluted cities in the world, but we have made it. We, the citizens, have made it. And we have to work collectively. And from those efforts in last 4 years, I can say that air quality has actually improved a lot. Every day, I'm sure you must be reading in that this is one of the best time in last 10 or 10, 20 years of air. And that is because a lot of strict action have been taken, a lot of ecological steps have been taken. The green cover of Delhi has increased 600 acres, which is huge in terms of land. Delhi is a tight, Delhi has a different situation on land. A lot of initiatives have taken, like diverting the trucks outside Delhi. So things are improving, but all of us have to contribute to that. Especially Delhi has become infamous because there is a particular time around November, and that's becoming when this parali jo burn karte hain uska dhua idhar aata hai Delhi mein, us waqt hamare haath se, sabke haath se situation nikal jati hai. उस वक्त तो बस ईश्वर से प्रार्थना कर सकते हैं कम आए, बट उसके अलावा जो सेल्फ जनरेटेड पॉल्यूशन है उसको तो हम बहुत कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं. गवर्नमेंट भी एफर्ट कर रही है, सिटीजन का पार्टिसिपेशन भी बहुत रहा है इसमें.
एंड ऑफ कोर्स द फोकस ऑन पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट, आप हैज आई थिंक बीन अ लिटिल बिट स्लो ऑन पब्लिक बसेस, बट आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क, यू हैव मेंशन इन द बुक दैट यू नो टुडेज पॉलिटिक्स वांट इंस्टेंट रिजल्ट्स, व्हिच इज व्हाई एरियाज लाइक एजुकेशन डोंट गेट सो मच फोकस, बट आप ऑल्सो सडनली इज इन सम इंस्टेंट मोड, बिकॉज फॉर वेदर इट्स फ्री water, whether it's water arrears waived, whether it's every day there's a new SOP announced by AAP. How do you balance the long term funds for things like education and health and all the funds that are being paid by the taxpayer on all these SOPs just before elections?
We are spending money on public is paying taxes and we are spending money on them,
but water,
we are not siphoning off money.
Nay, but water arrears means people who paid the bills then
actually few of the things we have to penalize. Few of the things we have, especially in water areas, we have to understand that few of the things are notional at times. Kisi ke ghar mein water meter wala nahi jata tha, ab wo apni badmashi se, apne laparwahi se usne khub sara bill bana rakha hai us pe. I know cases aur us pe 1 lakh rupaye ka bill aa raha hai. Ab agle mahine ka wo bill isliye nahi de pa raha hai kyunki aapne pehle 1 lakh rupaye ka nahi diya, wo dena cha raha hai. He says ki I want to pay my 2000 rupees of this month, but I can't pay which I have not spent, I have not used. So many things are notional. That's why we waived off. Ki usme se jitne, I'm just clarifying on one thing, but usually when you say free SOPs, it's not free SOPs. It's paying back. Free water provided 4 years back is actually paying now. Delhi ke log, Delhi mein water meter connections nahi the. Free water meter, free pani unhi logon ko mila 4 saal mein, jin logon ne पानी बचाया, जिन लोगों ने मीटर लिया और फिर उन लोगों ने पानी बचाना शुरू किया, उसकी वजह से आज पानी और लोगों को, जब हम दिल्ली में आए थे 58% लोगों को पानी मिलता था, आज 83% लोगों को पाइप्ड वाटर मीटर से, पाइप्ड वाटर सप्लाई से पानी मिलता है. सो ये पानी उन लोगों से बचा जो वेस्ट करते थे, क्योंकि अब उनको लगा कि यार अगर हमको 20,000 लीटर के दायरे में रहना है, फ्री लेना है, तो चोर बनने से अच्छा है 20,000 लीटर तक खर्च करो और कम रखो, मतलब करो, लोगों ने कम खर्च किया. सो इट्स ए वाइज इकोनॉमी.
But is it also a wise decision given that elections are coming? And have you realized that while the transformation of government schools, mohalla clinics is all very well, that doesn't win you elections? We saw one advisor who worked very closely on education, Atishi, lost her Lok Sabha election. So do you feel that things like education win elections?
I think we have been doing what we have thought. As we came to power, we subsidized the electricity. We fulfilled the promise of giving free water in the very first month. We came into power in 2015, February. Within 1 month, all these decisions were taken and things started rolling. As we are closing this tenure, we are working on different things that we have been thinking on working. Like water, electricity, we have been working already. Other things you call free.
Free for women in the metro and buses.
Yes, in metro, yes. People, women's security, working condition for women, from the, all those points, we found it useful, so we introduced this. And we have money for that. We are not asking. I mean, people are paying money. This government is spending money to make their life better. We are not siphoning off that money. In other states, people are siphoning that money.
Why do you think education is not a vote mudda? Why do people not vote on education? Why do people vote on things ki, on different things?
It's never tested, actually. मुझे याद नहीं है कि देश में किसी भी पार्टी ने इलेक्शन लड़ा हो एजुकेशन के मुद्दे पर.
आप लड़े?
हम लोग लड़े थे एजुकेशन. हम लोग जब चुनाव लड़े थे 2015 का और 13 का, इट वाज अ मूवमेंट. दिस वुड बी फर्स्ट टाइम अ पार्टी वुड बी कंटेस्टिंग इलेक्शन ऑन द वर्क ऑफ एजुकेशन दैट द पार्टी हैज डन. एंड दिस वुड बी द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया कि एक पूरा का पूरा राज्य का चुनाव एजुकेशन के मुद्दे पर लड़ा जाएगा. एंड आई एम प्राउड ऑफ दैट.
बट फिर वाई डू थिंक कि लोकसभा में ये नहीं हुआ?
लोकसभा में अलग अलग लोगों के वो थे, क्योंकि हो सकता है लोग दूसरे दृष्टि से सोच रहे थे. दिल्ली में लोग अलग मतलब राज्य के मुद्दे पे अलग सोचते हैं. उड़ीसा वाज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एग्जांपल, जहां एक ही समय पे वोट हो रहा था. लोगों ने एक वोट डाला नेशनल गवर्नमेंट में किसी के लिए डाला, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट में किसी के लिए डाला. दैट वाज विद इन अ डिफरेंस ऑफ 30 seconds. एक आदमी पोलिंग बूथ पे गया तो 30 सेकंड के अंदर दूसरे बटन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट पे किसी और पार्टी को दे रहा है, नेशनल गवर्नमेंट पे किसी और पार्टी को दे रहा है. यहाँ तो 8 महीने का डिफरेंस है.
डू यू थिंक प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी वाज द रीजन आतिशी एंड राघव लॉस्ट?
मे बी. आई मीन उसके बहुत सारे अलग अलग डायमेंशंस हो सकते हैं देखने के, बट यस, मोदी जी की पॉपुलरिटी बहुत है और बहुत थी.
But we're in the last round, so if anybody has questions, they can just raise their hands. Go ahead. You have a question.
Sir, do you think that reproductive education is a concept that will corrupt the minds of Indian children or make them more aware and careful about their health and safety? Do you think that it should be a formal subject like in the United States in order to combat the issue of overpopulation, which is in a chain reaction, a cause for unemployment and to some extent poverty in India?
Sanskari education versus sex education.
Everything that is needed to live a life should be taught in a school, in a scientific manner. Everything. I say with religious practices, I say with sex education, health education. Unfortunately, हमारे देश में बहुत बात हुई इस पे, sex education पे भी बात हुई. But the problem is कि the whole discourse turned into a discussion कि sex करने की सही age क्या हो, या उसके फांसी लगाने की सही age क्या हो, किस पे. I think ओपन डिबेट्स होनी चाहिए और बच्चे के अंदर के बहुत सारे टैबूज को तोड़ना चाहिए. 5 साल 10 साल पहले तक मेंस्ट्रुएशन पे बात करना भी एक बड़ा टैबू था. आज विद प्राइड वी कैन से कि हम अपने स्कूल्स में बहुत ओपनली एजुकेशन दे रहे हैं इस बात पे, और लड़कियों को नहीं, हम लड़कों को भी एजुकेशन दे रहे हैं. आज हर स्कूल में एक कॉरिडोर में डिस्पेंसर लगा होता है जिसमें से एक लड़की पैड निकाल के यूज कर सकती
है. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
और इट्स नॉट ए मैटर ऑफ शेम नाउ. So things are improving. बहुत radical changes नहीं हो सकते हैं, क्योंकि thoughts, social thoughts और school के scientific thoughts दोनों के बीच balancing बना के हमको चीज़ introduce करेंगे तो conflict नहीं होंगे, नहीं तो society rebel करेगी. या society rebel ना भी करे, बच्चे के अंदर से society से कुछ और सीख रहा है कि नहीं नहीं इन मुद्दों पर बात नहीं करनी चाहिए, अचानक उसको लगेगा क्लास में ये सब पढ़ाया जा रहा है तो वो फंस जाता है. ग्रो कर रहा है समाज और स्कूल हेल्प कर रहे हैं, इट्स गुड.
Finally, as I said, Mr. Sisodia, you have elections coming.
Yeah.
You've started a movement. It's only been 4.5 years. What happens if AAP loses the elections?
No. AAP is going to win.
No. I didn't know you did astrology also, but...
No. But you see, wherever I go in Delhi, people say ki is baar aapko wapas leke aana hai. Aur ye jitne reforms hue hain, inko aage leke chalna hai.
Well, we wish you all the best, because if nothing else, I think the reforms in education and health are something which AAP has started, but every government, whoever the next government is, must carry on. And we hope that Manish Sisodia and his dedication to changing the lives of India's children continues whatever happens. Thank you very much, Manishji. Thank you all very much for being part of this. Thank you.